And today we're going to do a little challenge. It's called Cookie in the Face. And what they're going to do is they're going to try to move their faces to see if the cookie falls in their mouth. Are you guys ready to do the challenge?
Yeah.
All right, let's try. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Daniel and the Lion's Den. And Daniel was actually a man of God, and he was actually in a den with all these lions, and they really wanted to eat Daniel, but you know what? God didn't allow that to happen. So today, as we see, we had this little challenge. It was a little difficult to put the cookie in the mouth while using our facial expressions. Just like that, Daniel wasn't eaten by those lions. Even though those lions really wanted to eat him, he didn't. They didn't touch him. So just like it was challenging for us today, it was challenging for those lions not to eat Daniel. So today we're going to read a little bit more about Daniel and the Lion's Den. That's us. Thank you. Bye, Bridge Kids. Bye.
rejoice always, pray constantly, and give thanks in everything. For this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18.
We're in Brickle.
Brickle has a metro mover.
Come on, let's go explore Brickle.
Get your hand sanitizer.
For the last couple weeks, we have been hearing stories about the Israelites in Babylon, which is where they were taken as a consequence of their sin because they weren't trusting God or obeying God, and so now they are slaves in Babylon. But we see how God is still with his people, and he has shown his power in the way that he saved Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from the fire. And then last week, we saw his power used in Daniel to be able to tell King Nebuchadnezzar about his dream and that he should repent of his pride or he would be turned into, or he would act like an animal, which happens. And so today our story is also about Daniel. And he is now an old man. This story happened many years later, and King Nebuchadnezzar is no longer the king in Babylon. Now there is a new king. But we'll see that even though Daniel is old, he still loves God and obeys God most of all. So let's watch what happens.
King Darius was the new leader in Babylon. Babylon was a large kingdom, so the king picked men to be leaders over small parts of Babylon. The king picked Daniel to be one of the leaders. Daniel was very good at his job. So Darius decided to put Daniel in charge of all of Babylon. When the other leaders heard about this, they were jealous. They watched Daniel and waited for him to do something wrong so they could get him in trouble. But Daniel did what was right. The leaders knew Daniel obeyed God, so they made a plan to get Daniel in trouble for praying. They said to King Darius, "King, all of your leaders think it would be a good idea to pass a law. For the next 30 days, no one may pray to any god or man except to you. Anyone who disobeys the law will be thrown into the lion's den." King Darius agreed to pass the law. Daniel knew the law meant he was not allowed to pray to God. Still, Daniel went into his house and prayed to God 3 times a day, just like he had always done. The jealous leader saw Daniel praying, and they told the king that Daniel had broken the law. What? King Darius was upset. He didn't want to punish Daniel. The king thought all day about how he could save Daniel from the lions. "The law can't be changed," the men reminded King Darius. So King Darius ordered Daniel to be thrown into the lion's den. "May the God you serve save you," he said. The king went to his palace for the night. He did not eat and he could not sleep. He thought about Daniel with the lions. As soon as the sun came up the next morning, the king hurried to the lion's den. He cried out, "Daniel, has your God rescued you from the lions?" Daniel shouted back, "God sent his angel to shut the lion's mouth. I am safe." The king was so happy. He ordered for Daniel to be taken out of the lion's den. Daniel wasn't hurt because he had trusted in God. King Darius made a new law. Everyone must respect God. King Darius wrote, "He is the living God. He has rescued Daniel from the power of the lion." God showed his power to rescue Daniel from the lions, but Daniel was just a small part of a much bigger story. God ultimately rescued us from a much bigger problem, sin and death, through his son, Jesus.
Daniel to get thrown into a pit of lions. Do you think maybe God made Daniel invisible so they couldn't smell him or see him? Or maybe he made them really nice so that Daniel could pet them like kitty cats. Or maybe he just made them not hungry so that they just ignored Daniel. But did you know that this was a really common way for people to get killed back then? And they would keep the lions extra hungry so that they would be mean and ready to eat as soon as someone was thrown in. So this really showed God's power. And we see that Darius really liked Daniel, and he thought he was a good leader. Daniel had shown him that he was a trustworthy servant. And these other people were just jealous of Daniel and wanted to get him into trouble. And they knew that he wouldn't stop praying because Daniel prayed every day, 3 times a day. So have you ever wondered, like, why would God let something so bad happen to someone who loves him? But we see in a lot of these stories that God allows really hard and scary situations to happen in our life. But there's always a reason. God is always doing good out of these hard situations. So let's think of some of the good things that have happened. So Darius gave glory to God, and everyone was able to see how powerful God was through this situation. And don't you think that Daniel, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, don't you think that his faith was stronger because of the way that God saved him? It would change you. And so God is doing a lot of good things through this. But sometimes it might feel like God's not listening to our prayers. And sometimes God doesn't answer our prayers the way that we think he should. And we've got to ask ourselves, why do we pray? We pray because we trust God, and we know he hears us, and he tells us to pray. He wants us to talk to him because he loves us. He loves to hear from us, and he wants us to hear from him. He created us to have a relationship. Think about if you went all day and never talked to your mom or dad. That wouldn't show that you had a good relationship with your mom or your dad. So God wants us to talk to him, and God is always listening. He hears us, and he will help us, even if it's not the way that we think he's going to help us. Sometimes he surprises us. But God is trustworthy, and he is faithful. And you know what? He is probably not going to ever have to save us from lions, but you know, God saves us from something so much bigger and more dangerous than lions. He saved us from sin and death, and he did it through Jesus. So this story points us to Jesus and how he is going to save us from our greatest enemy. And he is able to do it because he's all powerful and can do anything. So let's take some time to answer some questions about this story and check out our Bridge Kids website for more things you can do this week to grow in your faith and to practice praying. There's a lot of things on the website to help you develop your relationship with God through prayer. We'll see you next time.